started just obviously with the guitar. Basically, just was playing about. I was just sitting playing about with A minor and G, and that's what I was doing. I was just sitting down playing about, and then I thought about trying to write a song with a kind of intro and a build up. And it wasn't until later that it became a kind of that kind of beautiful Southy kind of thing. But it was kind of basically I wanted to start a song with kind of. For there, I liked. I was dying to get Elegantly Wasted in, which is an Excess album. So. An Excess have also got a song called Show Me Cherry Baby. So I was trying to get them in, and then basically the song then started to build, and I tried to make it about an experience that maybe when guys are dating back in the day, and they meet a girl and they go on about themselves too much, and a girl gets bored and walks away, and that's the kind of idea. But also getting wee quirky bits in, like one of the lines is on to the next one. She was bold. Her favourite song was Fool's Gold. So I had the image of a girl with the Adidas on. Strolling Adidas trackies one or something, I don't know, but just that these are the images that come into my head. And then I thought it'd be nice to do the wee breakdown bit, which I was kind of finding I had to work on. I can't play an F, so I play this kind of, I don't know what it is, but it's just one down from a C kind of thing. And so I kind of went, so that's like the C, F, C, G, and I wanted to have a breakdown from the kind of. From that bit and then into. But I lost it from the start. And it was to try and get words that fitted. But I lost it from the start. So that bit, which I'm not great at singing, that was mainly from the likes of Beautiful South. I kind of had that in my head, and then having the band coming in with that. And then obviously the D's always my build up. And then into the. Then on to the next one. On to the next one, she was bold. Her favourite song was Fool's Gold. She broke the mold. And the dictionary part, didn't know her well, think her name was Cherry, which gets Cherry in from Show Me in Excess. She knew every word in the dictionary. Now, because of that, that brings me to the date that I had years ago in London, in Clapham High Street, with a Polish girl, and it was outside a bar, and I'm talking away in my Scottish accent, which I'm probably doing just now, talking too fast, and she keeps reading a book. And that book's a dictionary. She's trying to work out what I'm saying, because obviously it's a Polish to English dictionary. And yeah, so that was for production. I've invested quite a lot in like music equipment for our studio, which is the Pelikan Cave, and we've decided to. We'd spent a lot of money with previous productions, which went well. So obviously, at first, we used JP Reid of Medals, Yes Dragon, and Man Majuk Juk fame. A shout out to JP, who's a tremendous producer. So he did our first tunes, Feel the Pain, Industrial Shepherd, and Podium Queen, and Anchor Lane, which is all out just now. So he did them. Our bass player, Andy, his son Tony is brilliant at the whole production game as well. So he produced Crawl and The Vet. And because we did this studio, Gavin, our keyboard player, decided to get into production, and we produced Lie to Me was our first one. So our last singles were on production. And because of that, and because we've got our own room now and we've bought all the equipment, and Gavin's producing skills are tremendous. They've been really great. We really liked Lie to Me, and this one as well. He's worked really hard on this, and we're really proud of this song. So we produced it ourselves. It was quite important for me to get a good intro to the song. The start with the bass drum or whatever he's playing, I don't know drums, but that was to represent a heartbeat. So bum, 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 love heartbeat, and then it's kind of the kind of intensity, if you like, of the intro is a juxtaposition to what the song's about. So so you've got the intensity of going on that date, and then into the kind of lovey-dovey, beautiful Southie type vibe with a brilliant bass for Andy in the song that kind of drives the song really nicely. So yeah, that was the production process. The song, we did it ourselves. So the middle part of the song, of the breakdown, it's a Pelikan old thing we always do, that we have a breakdown kind of 2 minutes into a song. Lie to Me's got it, Podium Queen's got it, Vet's got it. I don't know, it's just the structure, how I write songs, that's just the way it is. But it needed something at the end bit, and I thought it would be good to have a female coming in to kind of do a kind of me to you type thing. Like, so she would say why the love died. So Sophie had sang backing vocals on The Vet. She's a great wee singer, she's got a fantastic voice, and it's Gavin's daughter as well. Like, our first take of it was tremendous. And she wrote the, so she wrote that bit, so that bit in the song, she wrote the kind of reply, and it just works so well in the song. It's some people's favourite bit, where it breaks down and then it goes into the end of the song, and I think it complements the song brilliantly. It needed something different, and I think we made the right decision with bringing Sophie in there. Expectations of the song, we've no major expectations, just to do better than the last song really, and build our profile, and hopefully people like it. So the expectation is the song will get more streams in the same period of time that Lie to Me did. We are organically building, we're following, and we're doing really great, and we've got some tremendous support. So I just like keeping it like that organically, and at least we know that the people that are listening to us like us, they continually support us. And it's good to have that base, that foundation. For every song we put out, we just want to get a wee bit better, and that's the expectation for this song. Yeah, we've got loads coming up music-wise. Mill Street Blues should be out in the summer, well, we're hoping, because it's a very summery song. Very Boys of Summer, if you like. And we're looking forward to bringing that out. French Girls is another song we've got in the pipeline. Yeah, we've got loads happening, and hopefully we just keep building and what we've been doing, build, we're following, and building what we've been doing. Ooh, I thought I liked her.